So in this presentation, we're going to look at the insulation resistance test, the third dead test according to BS 7671. So we've done the continuity of protective conductors, including main and supplementary bonding. We've done continuity of ring final circuits, and we're ready now to carry out the insulation resistance test. As you can see, the installation has been locked off. I've also proved the installation is dead, which I've shown in a previous presentation. And now we're ready to continue with the insulation resistance test. So let's just recap of what's happened up until this point. Hopefully during the continuity test, we've left all circuits in the on position. So cooker switch has been left on, all switch socket outlets have been left on, so the insulation resistance test will get to the front of the plate. My switching sequence for the lighting circuit has been left in the on position, and these two switches are two-wayed and they have been left on. This is a one-way switch. We've just got to now confirm that all loads have been removed. So in this case, the three lamps need to be removed. And also the electronic devices, which is the RCCBs, need to be left in the off position. We do not want to pass the test voltage of 500 volts DC through those electronic components. We have no other sensitive items in circuit, such as digital time clocks, smoke detectors, etc., PlayStation TVs, that could be damaged during this test. So we're possibly now ready to look at doing the insulation resistance test. So I moved towards doing my insulation resistance test. I just want to recap what I've done with the terminations within the consumer's unit. During the first two tests, continuity of protective conductors and continuity of ring final circuits, I've returned the tightness of these connections within the consumer units back to manufacturer's rated Newton meters of torque. So at this stage, at test three, I don't particularly want to start removing conductors from the consumer unit for the insulation resistance test. However, BS 7671, when it shows you the model forms for recording your test results, suggests the insulation resistance test must be done between live conductors, so in other words, between the line and neutral, and between live conductors to earth. So in other words, we should have a combined line and neutral together test to earth. Often missed, what we generally do is line neutral, line earth and neutral earth, three tests, but there's only two boxes in which to record, and it requires a combined test of the live conductors together to earth. So I'm going to show you how I come up with a way of getting round doing this test without removing the conductors and without doing all three tests and then just saying, well, I'll record the worst reading of between line and earth or neutral and earth, whichever one's worse, I'll put that in the box. BS 7671 requires us to do a combined live conductors to earth, and that's what we would do in this test. Also, I suggested that I'd left all switches in the on position, which I have. However, upstream is another consumer's unit, and I've actually left the isolator in there in the off position. I only want to do the insulation resistance test for the circuits within this part of the domestic dwelling and record them on my schedule of test results. The second consumer unit will have its own set of test results for that consumer's unit. So I think we're now in a position where we're possibly ready to do the insulation resistance test. So see how we're going to do that. So shown on previous video presentations, I'm going to set my Megger MFT up in order to carry out insulation resistance. For us, it's in the red scale and we're going to need to put it onto 500 volts DC. And I'm going to short together my conductors to prove the leads have not become broken. I'm also going to use a link again this time that I've used before on continuity testing. So I'm going to link these together to prove I've got a short, and I've got a slightly older test probe that I can get a more of a connection with my crocodile clip and still have some tip exposure. Okay, so that's going to be really handy when I'm trying to do this combined live conductors to earth insulation resistance test. So press my test button and I have a dead short. So we're happy the instrument is ready to carry out the insulation resistance test. I've got a small tweak on how I'm going to do it here to combine my live conductors to earth test. So let's see how that looks inside the consumer unit under test. So I'm ready to carry out this combined live conductor, so line and neutral, to our earth connection. So I've got my probe already connected onto my earth bar. I've got a Megger MFT lead, this time one of the older style ones with more tip exposed, is a dead test, so it's not an issue. I'm going to put one end of my crocodile clip onto there and the other crocodile clip onto the neutral bar for the first circuit under test. So when I now probe into the top of my circuit breaker, I've got a linked live conductors to earth for the test for the insulation resistance. Press and hold the test button and I've got a reading greater than the machine can read, so in this case greater than 999 megohms. I pull off And I'm going to move my crocodile clip now onto the next one, which has two circuits served from the RCCB, and repeat the test again. So I'll go into the top of the first circuit breaker. So live conductors to earth. A reading greater than the machine. I move across to the next one. Again, greater than 999 megohms. I move the crocodile clip again. So I've now linked the final circuits over here. So the neutral and line conductors are linked together on top of the circuit breaker. Greater than 999 for live conductors to earth. And move again to the next one. And again, greater than 999 megohms. So I've now did a combined live conductors, line and neutral together to the earthing conductor. I'm now required to do a test between live conductors. So I need to test now between the line and neutral of each of the circuits. So we go back now to our test probes. So I've moved back to my conventional probes. I've linked onto the first neutral bar and I'm going to test between that and the top of the first breaker. So we go in, press and hold my test button. Between live conductors, I've got a reading greater than 999 megohms. I move across to pick up the next two. And we repeat the process again. And then finally move it to our third, in our case, neutral bar, and the final two circuits. And then the last one. And all of those readers were greater than the machine can read, so greater than 999 megohms. However, no need to get excited just yet. We've still got to go back into the installation and throw our two-way switches back into the opposite on position and repeat the insulation resistance test for that lighting circuit again. So let's go into the installation and do that. So the consumer is isolated, completely dead. I've locked it off in the double pole switch or link main switch in the towers itself. I'm now going to walk off into the installation and throw all those two-way switches back into the other on position. I only have one set here. So this set of two-way switches need, first of all, one switch turning off, one switch turning back on, and then I go back to the consumer's unit and do the insulation resistance test again for that circuit. So with my two-way switches now thrown into the opposite on position in order to do the insulation resistance test of the other strapper, I can repeat the test for that lighting circuit only. So I'm still onto the between live conductors, between line and neutral. Got a reading greater than 999 megohms. I'm now going to replace one of my leads. Going to link together the live conductors. Connect onto my earth bar and do the final test now between live conductors together to earth. And a greater than 999 megohms. I've now completed the insulation resistance test with the live conductors together to earth and between live conductors, in other words, setting between line and neutral. I've repeated the test for the lighting circuit that had the two-way switches in when I've thrown them into the opposite on position in order to test the other strapper. I now believe that these results can be added to my test paperwork and the insulation resistance test is now complete. Hope this video has been some help.